finally things opened up.
I remember watching that game. Okay, the way he was throwing, I thought he was going to be able to hit that no hitter.
Andy Crawford broke it up with a single. Dylan Moore would later homer in that inning. Zach Plesac. You know, it ties to something interesting because he put together two of the worst starts of his career back in late April against the White Sox twice. The White Sox had two consecutive starts. He was able to work 5 2/3 in two starts combined, and they hung 12 runs on him. And he was hungry to piece it back together. As a matter of fact, after the start on April the 14th, when he went 2/3 of an inning, 7 hits, I should say, in 6 runs, he went back to work, looked at a lot of the metrics, the video, and hoped it would get better against the White Sox. All he did was pitch a little deeper, but gave up 6 more.
He's a high-energy guy, so you have to try to get him in an uncomfortable position as far as starting to try to overthrow. That's how you get back in.
One and oh, the count to Drew Butera. Down the middle. 1-1 the count. You ever have a teammate work against a pitcher? My memory, it doesn't serve me of a guy that had such a short arm. I really am calling it the catcher's delivery.
Remember Kenny Hill used to have a short arm delivery.
It's a good one. Former Angel.
Montreal Expo. Texas Ranger.
Isn't that funny, too, because you think about all we're taught as pitchers, use your leverage. Lubezar, you're a big guy. Use your leverage, right? He was a big guy.
Yeah, he
short armed the baseball.
Yeah, you're always taught to get as much behind the baseball with that arm delivery. You're seeing a lot more pitchers, though. Lucas Giolito has really shortened up his arm delivery now. I remember even in high school how long his delivery was. Now he's shortened up. He brings it right out of the glove and up to his shoulder. Very similar to Plesac.
To the count to Drew Butera.
Even if you look at Griffin Kennedy, he was a little bit of a short on that. Quite like this, but very similar.
Butera puts it on the ground. Easing on in on a backhand making the play. Rosario and Ed Rosario. 2 outs in the inning. Here in this ballpark, when we think of guys that were catchers turned pitchers that maybe used that similar delivery, we love our old friend Percy. You know, we think of a guy who had that delivery and learned how to throw and learned how to power his arm as a catcher.
Kenley Jansen, the same thing for the Dodgers, former catcher.
Taylor Ward ready to roll down the line, foul ball though.
The way this is going for Shohei Ohtani, you're Taylor Ward. Get on base. Just get on base. One swing, you're right back in the game. Six extra base hits this year for Shohei Ohtani. 40 strikeouts and 25 2/3 innings pitched.
Jose. Any Peg had a great interview with Ohtani last night. I think it's fun for the fans in house and those that hear the interview, certainly for those of you watching on your device or on television, to listen to the words immediately after the game of Ohtani. Not in a pregame Zoom, like a real life, real interview. We don't have those anymore. Don't miss Zoom. Don't miss it at all when it's gone. Looking forward to talking to players, you know,
yes.
Human beings. Don't miss it.
I hope this doesn't take too long. I'm double parked.
Yep.
Oh, it's an I'm one?
Your cousin.
From Boston.
Woo! Back, baby!
Hands on me!
Indoor beers! Indoor beers!
Did I get the shot?
Nope. You saw the needle and passed out cold.
Here you go. Continue to wear a mask.
So you can see the only way to access the game is on the cell phone, which we're screen recording. And I didn't touch it, but the game just shut off. Here you go. There's a low connectivity using the last available data. I'm not even on a data plan. This is all Wi-Fi. So that's a bullshit message. So now I've got to find where in the game I was. So we'll stop this so we can upload it and show how they're shutting off the game and me not even touching anything.